So, Josh.
Yeah.
Let me tell you about Wave Race.
Tell me all. Well, you know what? Let me tell you first, because okay. I suspect that you have a lot more to say than I do.
All right, you tell me about Wave Race first.
When Wave Race came out, my brother had an N64 and I did not. So I was very alone in this, and he never really taught me what was going on. He just kind of like, hey, here it is. Here's Wave Race. Have fun. So I did a lot of crashing into walls and not much else. And that's the story. What's your story? You tell me about Wave Race.
Well, let me tell you about Wave Race. When I was growing up, I did not go to Blockbuster. I went to a very sub brand named store called Movie Gallery.
I remember this.
It was across the street from a Walgreens.
Yes.
And they did not have quite the huge selection of video games. And among other things, Chameleon Twist, which we will play on this channel at some point.
Mm-hmm, mm-hmm.
Some blow-up puzzle game, Super Mario 64, Star Fox 64. They had Wave Race 64, which is... for adult me, 25-year-old me, the most frustrating game I have ever played in my life. Here's championship mode. Oh, I did actually beat Expert at one point. So
you did.
Here we go.
Beautiful.
Here's Expert. Select your watercraft. I like this dude.
You like that one?
All right, let's custom.
Looks like a tool. All
right. Oh, I cannot wait to be upset later. Here we go. Championship, 8 rounds.
8 rounds.
I give you 2 before I quit. I need 2 points to advance.
To third place.
That means I need to finish third or greater.
That's pretty nice.
You mean that you may need to have to provide
more
commentary because
yeah.
Provide commentary because I can't deal right now.
I like it so far. I've never actually played the way it was supposed to be played. So this is very interesting to me. I like how there are ice cream cones on the water. I feel like normal buoys would have been sufficient, but ice cream cones work for me.
But if they're buoys, you don't know whether you're supposed to go to the left or the right. Yellow means left and red means right.
I like that.
Yeah, it's kind of the split second problem where once you fall behind, you're effed. Like, oh my god, here's the part that makes me hate. So good. I'm in fourth, by the way. This game is subject to spontaneous resets. So get ready for that.
This game, you know, every now and then, the menu comes up and it retires automatically. I don't know what that's like.
Yeah, I had no problem with that. Restart that circuit.
8 rounds.
All right. I tell you what, if I reset one more time, I'll go back down to normal.
So is this a normal sport? Like, is this something that people actually do?
Is jet ski racing a normal sport? Yeah. Absolutely.
Interesting. Why isn't that in the Summer Olympics? Because I'd watch the heck out of that.
Isn't it? I would have sweared it is.
Maybe it is, and I'm just...
It's like how rodeo, like, barrel racing is a horse...
is a horse thing, yes.
Barrel racing is a sport compared to rodeo. This is literally impossible.
What happened? You got like
We're going back to normal because hang on, let's go back to hard, how about?
Yeah.
Oh god, I can't even I don't want to be the girl. Come on.
I don't wanna be the girl.
Don't get tired on me.
Yeah, I know, I'm sorry. I'm not the one who has to wake up at 6 either.
I know, right? You're just gonna go home and enjoy yourself.
Yeah.
I go home, and wake up, I fill up bags. I
fill up bags and money.
Full of money. Oh, you know!
Yeah.
It's almost like you work with me. There you go. Look at how much easier that is.
Oh, jeez.
Don't jump on the balls! Welcome to my life. We are gonna have this be a sub show about, games Johnny feels particularly strongly about, and I don't think we can do that anymore.
It's like, games that I just really don't like. or really like.
There it goes.
So I've been trying to get good at Dark Souls.
Oh my god, that takes a lot of effort.
And I haven't really gotten good yet.
I clapped for myself.
Oh, sorry.
Thank you for your patriotism.
I have not gotten good.
No, you haven't.
And I tried Bloodborne as well, which we might do that eventually.
I thought that was Blood Rain. That's not the same.
No, Bloodborne, but it's hard.
It's difficult.
It's
I get
so
you.
Hard.
Even as a person that doesn't play shooters or slashers, like. Is that going to be our gimmick? Is that I play the cheap kid stuff and you play the hackers and slashers?
Yeah.
That's cool.
I'm going to make you play some of them because I know that you're not great at it. Just like...
I haven't played... Okay, look, here's my... For example, Resident Evil.
Yeah.
Here's my experience with Resident Evil. I came over to your house once 9 years ago.
Yeah. Did you really?
Yes, Reed. You were still friends with... I'm going to censor this. Your good friend...
Yeah. Oh, and, I still am, sort of.
Oh, you said you weren't, but anyway.
It's complicated.
All right, well, we'll deal. And we played a little bit of Resident Evil 4. And that was my only experience. We played co-op Resident Evil 4, which I guess was only possible when... Darn it!
When you were right next to each other, yeah.
Well, when it was a third-person view.
Oh, actually, we have... It was Resident Evil 5.
No, I believe it was... You were in some desert place.
Yeah, it was 5.
Real?
Yeah.
Alright, well, 5.
Not that it makes a huge difference, but I actually have that right here.
Oh, good deal.
Yeah.
Well, I tell you what, once we finish the Nintendo series, we'll get right to slashers.
Yeah.
If our audience would like to see hackers and slashers, we'll do it.
Because, yeah.
I'm all about experiencing new things. Because if you stop hitting... The right buoy. I'm glad we're playing on hard, because this is severely frustrating. Stop it. Stop
no.
it. Stop it. Two. Two. Second
oh,
place.
No.
Two. Second place.
Oh,
still
no.
in second place. I have two strikes. You're about to watch a man get severely frustrated.
Look out for those waterfowl.
Yes.
That looks like it's a good idea.
No, it's not, because it slows you down.
Is it?
Yep.
Oh, that's unfortunate.
Fudge! Oh, guess I can't miss another one.
You'll be done.
Or I retire and I get no points. Well, there's my retire.
Retire.
Sweet.
You know, that's a very nice way of telling you that you suck.
He's such a douche about it. That's my favorite thing about this person.
I'm sorry, you've been disqualified.
He's such a douche. Okay, I have to finish in top half. By the way, this is one of my least favorite levels. Because the ocean, right?
Yeah, the ocean. There isn't a scarier thing out there than the ocean. Except for maybe spiders. For some people. Weak people.
I'm gonna... Whoa, are we gonna be like that? Because I'll be really honest, I'm not a big fan of spiders.
Really?
I'm really not.
Well, then your bloodline is weak and you will not survive the winter.
Real?
No, you'll probably be fine.
I'll probably be fine, but I still will make fun of you. Here's the thing, if I don't make it, I'm dropping down to easy or normal.
Yeah, yeah.
Because I have to beat this game in some regard.
In order to feel good about yourself?
This game demands that you be upset.
It demands.
Don't hit that box. I will kill you. Stop it! Here we go.
You know what the worst thing about crashing is so far that I've seen?
Yes.
It puts you in reverse.
Yeah.
You're like backwards when you come back. Oh no!
Son! Deal with this garbage! Past two people. Go.
Oh, do it.
Oh my god, I can't even deal.
Oh, that is legitimately scary.
What do you, water what physics, do you hit? Right? It's ahead of its time.
I know.
So I've already lost, so we're just gonna pack it in for the sake of doing a good job.
For the sake of looking like we care.
Maybe we'll do like a 4th of July special for this. When I come back.
You come back 4th of July?
Well, after we've been doing actual games.
Oh, yeah.
Oh, I'm sorry.
Oh. All that sea is choppy. They would have canceled this.
I tell you what, you guys have enjoyed a one-off so far.
It's good. Oh, look at those cardboard cutout people.
Look at those cardboard people. All right, points needed to advance. Please finish.
Oh, you're getting some good power going
there
on
here. There
you
go. Maximum power, in fact.
Maximum power!
I want to know what this voice actor is doing. Is doing post this.
Yeah.
So tell you what, after this episode, I'm gonna do some research.
Find out who he was.
Please put up his name. Oh yeah, that guy. Now, please put up the poster or album cover for something he's been doing recently. Oh yeah, that thing. I think I remember that.
I don't.
No?
I'm pretty sure I don't.
I don't think he's done anything past this.
I think this is the end.
This is the pinnacle of his career.
Unless we did find something and put it up. In that case, wow!
Look at that! Look at that thing he did! I'm sure he had to feed his family.
It's kind of like Macaulay Culkin.
Yeah.
Is that his name? It can't be his name. That doesn't sound like a name when I said it out loud.
Macaulay Culkin?
Is that
Mick
right?
Mick Culley.
Mick Culley.
Well, Edward Cullen is a word. Why can't Edward Cullen or Macaulay be a word?
I don't know. The guy from Home Alone.
Yes.
Yeah.
Macaulay Culkin.
Okay.
Are you worried that he stopped being this stuff?
I didn't think he was in anything.
Well, he was in Home Alone.
Yeah,
and Home Alone 2.
And then nothing after that.
Well, that's because he got old. And he didn't even get old. He had that weird puberty stage.
Yeah.
He's been in weird stuff since then.
Yeah, I mean, I saw him once on WWE.
Did you really?
Yeah.
All right, if we can find a picture of him on WWE, please put it up at this time.
Because, yeah, it was there. He was there.
That's wild.
He was talking to someone about something. I don't know.
Is that like, what people do, is they talk to people?
They talk to people. And, dude, this is like 5-10 years ago.
Oh,
like,
yeah.
Yeah. So.
Nobody cares about 2009.
No. Back when I watched a lot of professional wrestling.
You did watch a lot of professional wrestling. Here's the thing about you, is that my best friend in high school, which is you, and my best friend in college, both seem to weirdly watch a lot of professional wrestling.
And then suddenly none of it? Because that's what that's what happened to me.
I fell. Tell me about Gold Dust. To be really honest, I don't know what the deal is with him.
Gold Dust?
Yeah.
Jeez.
He just wears a lot of weird dust on his face?
I think so. You know, it's been so long, and he wasn't really one of the people that I paid attention to. My big guys were Rey Mysterio, and...
Oh, you gotta remember Rey.
The Undertaker.
Who's the guy, my roommate was a big fan when he was into wrestling. He was a big fan of the dude that did 619.
Rey Mysterio.
Oh, Rey.
Yeah.
Okay. He was a big fan of Rey.
Rey's a good guy. I assume.
And I'm... He might have been a douche.
He might. I don't know.
He might have been,
He might have been a total tool. He seemed like a good guy on set.
Yeah. Well, I gotta recommend this. Darren Aronofsky, who directs Requiem for a Dream, which I have recommended to you in the past on the show, directed a movie called The Wrestler.
Oh, yeah, with Mickey
Rourke. And, goddamn, what is the name of her daughter? I can't think of it, but, it's a very sad father-daughter movie. It's a fairly sad, wrestler movie. Have you heard of it?
The Wrestler?
The Wrestler, yeah.
Yeah.
He's washed up and he wants to go back in the ring because it's the only mistress that loves him.
Yeah, I remember it in general. I never watched it myself.
I did not watch it until recently, like a year ago. And he is very powerful in that. And I think that Mickey Rourke did not really have a career...
Until then?
Until it got rebooted.
And Mickey...
Until his career got rebooted, that is.
Yeah, Mickey Rourke or Mickey Rooney?
Mickey Rourke. I don't know why I said... Did I ever say Mickey Rourke? Mickey
no, Rooney? I thought of it because of the Animaniacs.
No, Mickey Rourke.
Mickey Rourke.
Mickey Rooney is an Animaniacs?
They have a song written about him.
Oh. Animaniacs is a weird show.
I loved it. It's on Netflix.
For real?
Yeah.
Why have I not watched this?
Netflix, give us money.
All right. That sweet, sweet placement money. No, I really dig Netflix, but yeah, well, I mean, one thing at a time, please.
Yes.
Mickey, I like Derek. I like Darren Aronofsky because he's a phenomenally depressing, mm-hmm. very well shot director. As you're going to learn as we do this series, I'm a big fan of movies. Aronofsky, Boyle, Kubrick, Fincher. I have very low opinions. I mean, I have very...
You have very low standards.
I like... No, not low standards. I like to go with the grain, you know?
Oh, yeah.
Yeah. So, Darren, he likes to make very depressing movies.
Mm-hmm.
Shot with a very, like, clinical realism.
I like clinical realism, too.
Unless, of course, you're doing, Requiem for a Dream, in which case you want to use montage as a way to explore drug addiction. And that is a very difficult movie to sit through unless you've watched it 5 times since you were born.
Oh, the box.
Stop
with
this box! This isn't the GameCube.
This isn't the GameCube!
Okay, while we're talking, I haven't been able to express this because this is one of the things I want to express about this game before we put it down for 4 or 5 months. the host, the announcer, is kind of a jackass.
Only a little bit.
So let's go ahead and observe a moment of silence while we listen to the host.
Sorry, you didn't accumulate enough points to move on to the next round. Better luck next time. Come back!
Look at you.
Yeah, look at my sweet forearms.
Your tan body. And your green butt, which I assume is just part of your skin.
It is.
You got 7 points.
You got 7 points! Look at that, I'm just so far ahead, you can honestly...
Just give me the trophy now.
I honestly think, to be really honest, this is the last level in normal mode.
Yeah. Look at this place. Why are we racing around a carrier?
So honestly, let me get really good at this game, and then we'll come back the 4th of July with something.
With something. We'll play some summer games.
Summer games done quick?
Yeah.
This is not a good game to do quick.
That'll take some planning. We'll
shoot something in June and then sit on it for a year. Boom! Oh god! Oh god! I didn't mean to! Please get up!
please get up!
I know, like, all I have to do to win is to finish, but... my pride.
I need 7s across the board.
Boom.
Is this the next level?
This is Southern Island. Final round. Oh, there you go. It's very nice of the game to provide context to where the climax is.
If only everything in life was that easy.
If any of you are looking for some suspense in your Let's Play footage, sorry.
There is none. We're pretty even keen.
I'll wait until I'm a little better at this because I honestly have not played it in 6 months to a year.
Oh,
shit, okay, we got difficulties now.
Beefed it.
Even though all I have to do is finish.
Is that a whale?
It is a dolphin or something.
It is a really big dolphin.
In cool stunt mode, you get to do something fun with that. Oh, God.
There's an orca whale.
It is a... Stop telling me what my life is.
What is up with these games and orcas?
Don't go that way.
Don't go that way. Have fun.
Let's go left, because the L means we go left. Stop it!
Why would you do that?
Oh, the anger is setting in, and I'm only on normal.
Oh, you are clearly beached. You are just done.
I'm beached.
That orca is, like, right next to the shore.
He's just hanging out, man. Just let him be what he wants to be.
He's right there.
Don't tell me what to do.
Look at
him. Maybe he's going to chill out and not eat me. That's cool.
Killer whales don't eat people.
He's here trying to eat dolphins in large amounts of krill all at once.
They do hunt shark. Orcas do hunt.
Hey, if I'm bored, please, please list the diet of orca whales on screen for me.
It's a lot.
You see, Josh?
Yep.
I bet I have at least two bullet points there.
Oh, you're a funny guy.
No, you're the funny guy.
We're the funny guy.
Yeah, well.
It turns out that I'm phenomenal at voice acting.
I'm digging it. We did, nine?
Oh, look at that.
What do we play?
Really fat guy.
Oh, he's very fat. That's his gag.
That's his gag. He's a fat one.
No, stop. You can be a person and still be overweight.
I know, I am one.
Yes. Is it like using racial language? Is that only you can do it because you're already a member?
No, it's all good. No disrespect, I just didn't, you know.
There's that bird.
You don't think about...
Round one,
fat
winner.
Raising, people raising.
Winner.
Winner, winner, chicken dinner.
Winner again.
You turn that off?
Winner. Winner a fifth time.
Winner again.
I got second place that time, but who cares?
I won. Is that really how it works in racing?
It's what, the person with the most points?
Theoretically?
That really is how it works.
Wow.
Well, enjoy yourself.
Yeah, I guess see you later on Not So Far, Not So Fair Racing. Bye.
Probably won't pick this up again until the 4th of July.
4th of July.
And I'm gonna be really honest. We're setting ourselves up for something here.
Yeah. It'll be fun.
We'll have to create flags.
Long-term commitment.
And stuff that people can't see. You mean you don't want to be an internet personality for like 6 months?
No, I'm into it. Let's do it.
I'm into it.
High five.
I just can't play that shit for a while.
All right.
And that was a medium quality high five.